Okay, well, hello and welcome back, everyone. I'm Bruce Brough with the National Foundation for Danish America, and along with the Danish Pioneer newspaper. We're glad you're joining us again. Our producer, Alice, is in Texas. I'm in Phoenix. Linda is not with us today, but she sends her personal greetings along with a hello from the Danish home in Chicago. She had another meeting today, so she had a conflict. So I'll do my best to fill in for her today. Benedicta is at her house on the Limfjord in Denmark, and you can see the beautiful view behind her through the windows. It's still light. We'll maybe see a beautiful sunset behind her tonight. This is program number 11, and it is, we will be going to Jelling, Vejle, Kolding, Lillebælt, and Bogense. We have one more tour remaining next week, March 16th. And we'll be traveling to Odense, Tosinge, Esko, Nyborg, Korsør, and Roskilde. Now, next week will not be the last program because we have added three special programs in the following Tuesdays, March 23rd, March 30th, and April 6th. And on the 30th and on April 6th, we'll be doing a program with the Skagen Museum, and we have a person we'll be talking to there, and we'll be talking about the artists P.S. Krøyer and Marie Krøyer on the 30th of March, and then on April 6th, we'll be talking about the artists Michael and Anna Anker. Now, on March 23rd, we have a special program we've just lined up. We're in the process of still lining it up. And I'm going to ask Benedicta to jump in here and tell us about this program we have coming up on March 23rd. What can you tell us, Benedicta?
Yeah, it is so exciting. All of you that have followed the session we have had saw when I had something from the paper cut museum at nearby in Jammerbugt when we were there. It is up in Hune, and it is a blockhus. And I just love the way the wonderful lady Karen Bitt Vejle, the way she worked with paper, what she can get out of the paper, what she, that's incredible. So anyway, we have then discussed here, Bruce and Linda and I and Alice, should we do something? And Karen Bitweiler, it was so nice. I said, thank you. I will be happy to be on one of the programs. So we will have a special program just about Karen Bitweiler's work, what she's thinking, why it's how it started, and everything. And that would just be gorgeous. That will be the 23rd of March. And we are going to have interview with her and so much more. So you can really look forward to something very special. And that is the same when we go to the Skagen Museum with the two sessions from Skagen. It will also be very, very, very nice. So you have something to look forward to.
That will be so much fun. And it, you know, and the timing is good too with the paper cuttings because it's just a couple of weeks before H.C. Andersen's birthday. So we can kind of celebrate Hans Christian Andersen at the same time.
And another important part of the Danish with the paper cut is also Easter. Easter, yes. Hans Christian Andersen started it, and then we make gækkebreve, we cut paper and we send them to people and we put flowers in, and that's all here about Easter. So that is so perfect that we can do it at the same time.
It will be good timing for the program. So we'll look forward to that on March 23rd. We have nearly 500 people registered for these programs. We sure thank you for signing up. And the recordings that we have on the website, they've been viewed 1,100 times approximately. So thank you. If you know of anybody that would like to view them, please send them to our website and just click on the recording button and you can view all of the past programs. And somebody had asked earlier, how long will you have the recordings available? And I can tell you this, we're in the process of setting up a new YouTube channel. We don't quite have it finished yet, but the recordings will be available for a long time, I hope. So we'll have them there and we'll tell you how to find them once we get everything set up. So I hope later in March, we'll have that finished. We've received a few donations. Thank you so much for that. It really helps. Also, it's helped us to extend and have the additional programs coming up. So thank you so much for your donations. Here's a few quick instructions. These sessions are recorded and the recordings will be made available on our website on the same page where you registered. So you can find them there for now. During the presentation, if you have any questions, please type them in the Q&A or in the comments section. I will be collecting them and reading them to Benedicta at the end of the program. And we'll get to as many questions as we have time for. If you have any technical problems at all, please click the raise your hand button at the bottom and we'll do our best to help you out. During the program, feel free to type comments. We enjoy reading the comments. And clicking on the comments button at the bottom, you can do that. And you can also enter questions there if you'd like. So thank you for joining us today. Now on to the show and welcome to Benedicta and today's program. Benedicta.
We are going on a different part of Denmark. We will be down by the Lillebælt as it shows you Gelling, Vejle, Kolding, Lillebælt, Bogense, and then I have added Kerteminde too, Munkebo, you will see that too. But anyway, it is a nice part to it, very different from what we have seen up to now. And I will show you the maps here. You can see where you are. This is completely different from where we have been before. But you see, it's up here, there is Aarhus, there is Viborg. And over here you have Copenhagen. So we are at the Fyn, but also everything south of Aarhus. Greisdalen is nearby Vejle, Jelling and Egtved, I have added that too. That is right here in very close to Vejle. And then we have the whole area by the Lillebælt. And then we have Kolding and then over to Bogense. And then over to Munkebo and Kerteminde. Kerteminde is up here, but I could not get it placed there. So that's our tour for today. And we will start. We're in Jelling. And Jelling, Kongernes Jelling, is it called the King's Jelling. And this is a very nice museum. And Jelling is the place, Kongernes Jelling is the birthplace for us as Christian people. Kong Gorm den Gamle, Gorm the Old, lived in 900 and died in 940. And then his son Harald Blåtann, he lived 935 to 985. Father and son, they lived there in Jelling. And they have the Kongsgården. We still have Kongsgården. We even have one here in Jarbæk. A Kongsgården is a place where the king, when they lived in Copenhagen, for example, if the king drove to Jylland and came nearby, for example, Jarbæk, then he could say, okay, I want to have an overnight at my Kongsgården in Jarbæk. And that was what Gorm den Gamle and Harald Blåtann, they had their king's gård in Jellinge. Those enormous rocks you see, these store sten, there is the runer. And here we see how Kong Harald said, Harald King Lodgør, the king did something. Komme disse efter Gorm sin fader. Harald learned something from sin, make some law from his father. And after his mother Tyra, mother sin, som Harald some vent Danmark. He tells that he won the whole Denmark. He was a big king, and he was the son of Gorm den Gamle. That is what it says on that runesten. And then on another side of the rock, it says, that's called the lion side, Løvesiden. Hele og Norden. He means I am the king for the whole Denmark and the whole Nordic countries. And then on the Christus side of the stone, on the Christian side of the stone, he says, and Danerne gjorde kristne, and they made it so we entered into be Christian people. So this is our ground place, the fundament of our beliefs in Denmark. Det er vores dåbsplads, birthplace. That is yelling. And that is the church. And you see some pictures for how pretty they have on the graveyards. The way they have cut those beautiful books. And there you again see the stone, yelling at Steen. And I love that graveyard because it is wild. Strawberry, and I think that is so smart to put a vilde jordbær på gravstedet, and it is green the whole year, and then to could even go and eat a little strawberry at grandfather's or great-grandfather's grave when you come there. I like it. And there you see. And that is how they made furniture for 1100 years ago in the Viking time, that they had this the Viking time is from 800 and to 1050. So we are here 900, close to 1000. And that was, isn't that a fancy table? That will be very in if we produce such a table. And then they could put a sail over. So it was like a roof with wool or cotton stuff, material they have woven head and over. So they can sit on both sides and then they have the nice table, long table. And there you see, there is not a single nail in, it's all made of the wood. It is just, they can take it apart, bring it along, put it together again. It is great. See how smart they were. And here we see the enormous grave. This is Store Gravhøje. Big graves here. And then you see the little Jellinge church in between those enormous graves. Danske Gravhøje. They are all protected. We are not allowed to go and dig, but there will come a story soon. And there you can see how it looks today. The little Jellinge Kirke and the graves, the enormous, you see people is standing way up there and you have the flagpole and the flag. And now we leave Jelling and go to Greisdalen. And Greisdalen is a beautiful forest, hills, trails going from Vejle, Greisdalen. And here you see some very special rocks. And there is something. That is a story. And here today, where it's just here, the 5th of March was 100 years since they found what we are hearing about here. Under this Bronze Age, for 3,000 years ago, in the big grave that you just saw, these enormous hills, they found an egekiste, a casket in oak, and they found a young lady, March the 5th, 2021. And det var ægte ved pigen. And here we will see that was the grave. They found this 3,000 years old oak. And in that, there was just a normal farmer. He come walking, he digged up. It was not allowed for 100 years now, but for 100 years ago, he could dig into the grave and he did. And he found that. The lady, that is her hair, her head, her dress, her bronze belt, and everything was here. Even a little built with some bones, burnt bones from a little child. They means it was 5 or 6 years old. She was buried there for over 3,000 years ago and found for 100 years ago. Nearby Ekved, and that was the oak, you see, the stamme that was hauled out so she could be put in there and there see what has been laying for 3,000 years. It is incredible. And here you see it how it is at the museum, at Egtved Museum, a copy of what's how she would look when she was alive, and you see the oak casket. And you see how we, and that is exactly Benedictine style, that is from the Bronze Age clothing, and that is 3,000 years old design, and we still use that. That is from the Equipines tid. And here, exactly because it's 100 years now, here for 3 to 4 days ago, 5 days ago, they have to, this year, to honor her, make in a wonderful Equipines trail. So people can come and walk that gorgeous scope på Egtvedpigens fodspor in her step, footstep from Vejle to Egtved Å. It is 14 kilometer walking trail. And there you have some of the trail. Beautiful, beautiful. And again here, and it is like coming to Austria, going down to Freistalen. And Jellinge and Vejle is very, very pretty, very hilly, nearly mountains. And there you see, god mad lavet fra bunden, as a good food comes from the ground. So, and that is Greisdalens Hotel. And I thought it was so nice with the basket and the canterelles. And here, all picked from the Greisdalen nearby Vejle. And that's Vejle with this hill, steep hills. And for you that has a child in Denmark, you will remember, I kan huske, at det var stejlt at køre. It was so tough to even can't drive through Vejle when we was children. Now we come over the bridge in Vejle Fjord. But bikers use it because it's good hills to train on. There you see, and then the view over hele Vejle. Så kommer vi til noget nyt. I like to show you some new Denmark too. I like the old part, but also so we are jumping 3,000 years now, nearly 4,000 years since the Egtvedpigen. And then that is in Vejle. This is Vejle Fjord. It is a new building. It is built of a company from Viborg, and the building is called The Wave, Bølgen. And that is apartments in the middle of the fjord. And it is the architect Henning Larsen there came up with that great idea. And it, they have got so many awards. And he was the same that created the opera when Mærsk Møller decided to pay for an opera in Copenhagen. It was the same architect. And also for the opera house up at Reykjavik at Iceland, that is the same architect. Berlin. And that is the mussels from Vejle Fjord. And here you see the Vejle Fjord bridge there. And you can see here all the rocks, and you can see how the mussels is growing on those. Yeah. And I love to make do bouquets all the time. So here's some of my bouquets put into this program from my garden from over years. And here we come to still Vejle, Vejle Fjord. This is Vejle Fjord Hotel, but also it has been a tuberculosis sanatorium since 1900. And it's so beautiful, you see how it is there. And that's from that time, tuberculosis sanatorium, and how the beds and how they had lights and all that to help the lungs and the disease. It is now a nice rehabilitation center and also a hotel. You can come there and stay there and have a nice time. You see, it's so pretty. And here it's the spa, salt spa at Vejle Fjord. And a normal swimming pool, normal spa at the hotel. Again, one of my bouquets. And the billiard. And in evening light, sunset light. And here we come to another funny thing. It is the Kirk Christiansen, the Lego family. They spent money on beautiful buildings And here they have decided to build a building in the middle of Vejle Fjord. It's called Lyst, so happiness. And this Lysthus, på dansk Lysthus, denne skønne, this beautiful building, is the architect Olafur Eliasson from Iceland that have made this gorgeous gastronomic world-class restaurant out in Vejle Fjord. See the inside interior. The Danish design is amazing. You see the sails like they are sailing on the fjord and so, and you can sit on this steel chairs. Oste, I love it. Isn't that an incredible design for a fork and a knife? En kniv og gaffel, lavet som om det er æblegrene. It could be apple trees from apple trees. It's so, I just like it. It is so pretty. And again, the restaurant. And see how they can look over Vejle Fjord from all sides. And see how they have used the tiles and different colors mixed. So compared to how the sun is shining, it will change the color. There you see it in Lisbon, you see the bridge, Vejle Fjord, and again, you can see it when you're driving up on the Vejlebroen, then you will see this beautiful Lysthus, paid of Kirk Christiansen labor family. Now we go to Kolding, and for you that are born and raised in Kolding, and also in Egtved, for actually very many people moved from Egtved, Jelling, Kolding to America. It was too tough for them. West of Kolding, very tough, not easy to be farming. So many of them, they decided to go to America. Here we have the wonderful castle. It burned and it had, when I was a child, it was just some walls left. There was nothing, but now it's built up. And it's one of our beautiful castles here in the middle of Denmark's south part. And you will see what's going on inside. See how pretty it is with Slottssøen in Kolding. And here we have Prince Henrik when he was alive in 2017. He had the exhibition, Jade, the green stone, or that was cut to all kinds of figurines and all. A big, big, big exhibition at Prince Henrik's private collection of Jade. And here we see there was 17 in 2019, Kolding Hus had 750 years anniversary jubileum, and then they had the exhibition Magten Smykker in a beautiful. Some of you that sits there in America asked me one day, why couldn't you take a photo when you went to Rosenborg in Copenhagen to see this gorgeous jubilee from the king and the queens, but here they brought it to Kolding. See them, diamonds and pearls. And here they are in beautiful montres, and that is all the way up in the history they have chosen to bring those gorgeous pieces to Kolding to celebrate 750 years in Kolding. The splendor of power, Magten Smykker. And a beautiful diadem also. Yeah. And there you see our three princesses or two queens or one princess, Queen Margrethe and Benedicta and Queen Anna Marie from Greek ex-Queen Margrethe, Anna Marie. And they are watching all this, what they normally use for when there is big fest and party in the Danish government and royal, everywhere in the Kongehuset gala. And that is Christian the Fifth Koringskåbe. When the king was at that time, then they had to wear this beautiful hermelin, like a mink, hermelinskåbe. And here, that is now 2021. And this year, we don't know because of the corona, but the plan is that here, the March 25th, it will open a big exhibition with 100 of our Queen Margrethe Her Majesty Queen Margrethe II of Denmark's private broderies. And that will go all the year 21, also into December, so we can go to Kolding Hus and see it and see how she sits there nice and work. And she did this gorgeous, gorgeous purse. It is made for Kronprinzess Mary, you can see, and you see the M, it could also be for Margrethe, but it is to Princess Mary. It is so pretty. Or one of her pillows. And that is the big, one of the big rooms at Kolding Hus. And you can see how it's still black from the time when it was burning. Now we leave that kind of Kolding, that place of Kolding, and we go to Kolding Fjord. And that was also a sanatorium for tuberculosis in old time. And you see how pretty, you can see how people could lay there and get sun and fresh air and all that, and there's a balcony. Today, it's very difficult to get placed, for there's so many guests there. Many, here you really can see how pretty it is. And it was built as a sanatorium, but for julemærke, the Christmas stamps I have told you on earlier in the sessions, and here in 1911, they had so much money, so they could start to build this sanatorium for children with lungs disease and different kind of illness. And that is from inside and out over Kolding Fjord. And here we see we had in 2018, we had Obama were here at the university in Kolding to talk business. And here he stayed as Kolding Fjord. And here he is standing with the staff. And there you see again a nice picture of how people can sit and enjoy it. And now we come to something very different. We come to whiskey. I have told you that Denmark make beer, you know that. And I told you that they make wine, and now you know that. But now I tell you that they make whiskey, and there is no border, only the fantasy set the border. And Danes, they just try, we try something new all the time. And here say whiskey distillery Trollen, that is from Kolding. And it's called Nimbus Single Malt, the one I have there. I did not have this, the Nimbus, but I had this Stauning, and it's still from the same. The map I have put in here is from a book about whiskey, and that is all the places where there are whiskey distilleries in Denmark. You see, it's everywhere, even over på Bornholm, so all the way around. And Trollen is the one in Kolding. And a beautiful, wonderful book about the whiskey is just came on the market very newly. And the editor of this book passed away for very, he was buried here Friday in Denmark. So that's a so sad story, very sad story. Family members too, Bruce and Doc Broke and the family Broke. Yeah. And now we go another wonderful part of many of you that have traveled with me. We have stayed there, for I have used Kolding. Like you can come if you want to, for example, jump under the Oberammergau Passion Play when we were there for 10 years ago. And then we could meet at Kolding and then take the bus down to Germany and Austria. So we don't need to go to Copenhagen and then have a longer trip. So anyway, we have used First Hotel in Kolding. It's a nice place just down by the rail train station and Kolding Hus. And that is in brand new style, you see that. That is Danish design, the newer style. And see the way they set the napkins, see the plates. And that is a whole group from America. Maybe you can see yourself. Yeah, and again, my flowers. And then we have this Campus Kolding. Kolding is this amazing town for students. South Danish University campus in Kolding. Very nice. And there you see a university. My grandson Frederik was there for 3 years and studied and ended up now will finish Copenhagen University this summer. But that is from Kolding. And you can see how they can look for the windows and all that for the shade. And again, University of Southern Denmark. And there was where President Obama was there to talk about international business at the university. And here you see International Business Academy in Colling, beautiful design. And then Design School Colling. And that's, and here you see Danish design. You see the egg, you see the swan. That is Fritz Hansen's Egil and Arne Jacobsen's the swan. Oh, a lot of swans in different colors. And I have to see if you can, yeah, maybe you can see a little bit. I don't know if you can see that it's actually more red outside the sunset along the fjord out here. I don't know if you can see it, but here you see also dress design, clothes design. I'm calling. And here's Benedict on Air Force One when we were on tours for years ago. And I was actually to the Obama ground tour down in Germany and Austria. And here's a hotel we have used again. That's also very nice in calling the Combin Hotel, Combin. And the Queen's Rose. And now we come to my sister's house. My sister Anna Meta and Sigurd was so nice to invite my group when I was here with a little group. We cannot come 40 people into a private room, but we were maybe 20 at that time. So here we were, and there you see how my sister has set it nice with this Georg Jensen table colossal and the cups and all that. And she had made, and I can remember that Paul Jurgensen, when he saw it, he said, oh my gosh, do you use figurines, the royal figurines on your tables? I said, yes, my mom always used them that way to bring them to, so you can enjoy them on the table, enjoy everything. That is what we like in my family. And there we have Napoleon's head and mashy pancake too. And then fricadella and rødkål, red cabbage. And mørbrad beef, tenderloin beef with onions over here. And so, and see, my sister put the bread in this little swan. And so that was nice of my sister to invite the guests for lunch in their house. And there they're sitting. And you see, she had the muselmalet, the china, the royal china, and again, figurines on the table. Yeah. And another royal china, that is Saxis Blomst, old pattern too. And here is Georg Jensen, not the watch and not the Georg Jensen silver, but this is tablecloths, and they are, the headquarters is in Kolding. And you see, that is the Easter tablecloth. Isn't it beautiful? It is in yellow, and it is with chicken, small chicken. It is chicken faces. See it, the little eye and the neb open here, and you see the wings here. But they're påskedun for Georg Jensen. And again, Michael Case. And here you see another Georg Jensen, that is Her Majesty of Sweden, Sylvia. She had Georg Jensen to design a table closet to her. And I actually owned also table the same, but just to King of Sweden. His wonderful tablecloths. I bought some, so I have had them for gifts for some people. And there you see juledun in white with the beautiful hearts that's all made in Kolding by Georg Jensen. And now we are going to a completely another one, the yellow rose, and you haven't seen this rose on this all my tours. This is Carl Nielsen's Rose, the composer Carl Nielsen. And for now we are going more to Fyn, and here we are down with Fredericia and Middelfart, and that is the old, you see here, the beautiful old Lillebæltsbroen coming over here, and there is a Hotel Trinity there. And Fredericia, well, they have this voldene in Fredericia, like dikes around Fredericia. And Fredericia Bymuseum, the museum in, and beaches down there, maybe you always would just pass on the freeway. Here you see also, again, a dike that cover Fredericia for water from the Baltic Sea, from Kattegat. And again, the dike around Fredericia, Volne. And that's why how I protect my peons from my garden, hang them up in my kitchen window, let them dry, can have them for years then. And here we come to Hindsgavl, a beautiful place. And this is Hindsgavl Castle. And that is what I want to show you. See how they have made stall and barns into hotel rooms. The tower you see here, that is the douche, that is the shower. There is the top, but here inside is the shower. You can see it's all stall. You can see how they have used the metal up to, and then they put some protecting up there too. It's not too high up. They have used all stone from the Svinestallen and Kostallen, from where the cows and the pigs were. That is now hotel rooms. And there you can see it is a shower in the tower. Yeah, isn't that something? Kostallsværelset. And the view. And then the Hubertus hunts once a year. And the old blacksmith house and a little beautiful summer house, but it's a house on the Hindsgavl. And there's a big national park nearly for where they're protecting, and they have this gorgeous deer. They're all about the Lillebæltsbroens, where we have the old Lillebæltsbroen, that's this area. There is a trail, 27 kilometer walking trail. Og Syrena. Now we come to the old Lillebæltsbroen. That was the day when it was ready. I say, okay, we can cut the ribbon and we can start driving. Lillebæltsbroen have train and car possibilities. The new Lillebælt, you cannot use that in the same way. There's also for train, but not in the same way. But here, there is the old bridge, and that was 1935. And you can see there's a flying, coming in, planes coming in to salute and all that for the opening of the Lillebælts. And this is the gorgeous. They worked on it from 1925 and into 1935. And then it was done. It's pretty. And this is one of the places in the world where you have very few places. There is Sydney Operan, Sydney Bridge. And then Gamle Lillebæltsbro, where you have bridge walk. And you can see that we are on the old Lillebæltsbro. And over there, you see the new one. That is how close they are together. So if you drive over the old one, you come here far, and then you come in behind into Middelfart. If you go another way with the new one, you just go straight direction, Odense, Odense. And that's the new one. And that was ready to be opened the 21st of October in 1970. And here you see from the opening of the new bridge, a plate made into celebrate that. And here again, a nice picture where you can see the old Lillebæltsbro, we have it here. And then we go over there, and there we have the new one from both. When you're there, you can see all through this and another way. Og det er Middelfart, and I know the name is funny in America, but det er what is called Middelfart, and it is the old harbor, and you can see it's gammel bydel, old houses, and you can see there actually a boat that have a name Solvang. Yeah. And the Middelfart, beautiful, small, bitty, tiny houses, two windows and a door, or four windows and a door. And that is a new bank. So again, new one all together. And once a year they have sailing around Fyn round, and 500 boats is sailing. And here they are, the final stop, Middelfart, after the Fyn round. And a new marina in Middelfart, beautiful. and people sit there and enjoy the sunshine and have a good lunch, a lot of fish and a little bit of snaps maybe. And then we have Kongebroen. We went, when I was 12 years old, we went to our school to this part, Kongebroen, was a place where we could stay for a week or 4 or 5 days with our school class. Det ved Kongebroen, hvad you see here. Og det igen, det er Middelfart, old buildings, church and harbor together. Again, Carl Nielsens Rose. Og her ser vi en kongedal, open have, altså en open garden, people that can come and see a beautiful garden i Søndersø på Fyn. So pretty. Så kommer vi til Bogen, så det er Købmandsgården. That's where people, that was the, at that time, the center, the shopping center, to go to the Købmandsgården. That was where you went to shop for coffee and sugar and butter and seed and everything, coal for your stove and whatever. Det var ikke Købmandsgården. Beautiful building. And they have rose fields på Fyn. They grow roses and see how pretty that is nearby Bogense. And Bogense new marina. And also old trees, if they could talk. And there we see it on how they put in everywhere in Denmark. We talked about it last time. The industry to Denmark, what is the main income to Denmark? And I was telling that industry is something and farmland is something, but tourism is really getting big. And here you see a completely new, but just in Bones, with these great summer houses built so people can stay in Bones, for example. And there you see, they are so American in style. They're so pretty, beautiful, big houses. Og sådan Sankt Nikolaj Kirke i Bogens, som er very pretty. Very pretty. Yeah. See this, the way it's built up. Og så kommer vi til Munkebo. Many of you have before the bridges, when you came with ferries, and so we went to the drive to the ferry. We always came past by Munkebo Kro, but then the new freeway came and we never come to Munkebo any longer, but you see that's a very old beautiful inn, so many of you there will remember, you can remember it from old time, and it's still there and it's so pretty. Og så til something else again, the Lego. Every time we buy a Lego something for our grandkids, some money goes in the good bank, and they are able, the Kirk Christiansen family and the son Thomas Kirk Christiansen is now the head of the company, and he have so many big missions, and this is a new golf course nearby Kerteminde. What do you mean? Isn't that beautiful? The great Norton Golf Spa and Restaurant in Kerteminde. This is the spa. And see the green, see the way it's put in. They say, it's just what I heard, that they have spent 400 millions kroner to build this one. And that is the hotel room. You are in a dive, and that is how the rooms is. And that is a spa. It is a bath. Actually, a bath. You walk down there and you sit in that bath. And that is the spa from front. Little kind of idea like the Sydney Opera. And here, that is when you are inside the room and you look out. And there you can see how you have a nice space outside and inside. And restaurants, more different kind of restaurants. and outside, and then all the islands you can go to when you want to play golf. I think it is very, very nice. That's the same family that built the Lyset I Vejlefjord, and here they have done it up on the northeast part of Fyn. And see the restaurant there. So if you come and you're a golf player, you'll have here new ideas to go to this great northern golf course in Denmark. And it is, we are coming closer to springtime, and this is Hvidtjørn, Kategus Hvidtjørn, a beautiful Hvidtjørn that grow in Denmark and special on some islands, Romsø and different places nearby Kerteminde. See how pretty. And a beautiful forest lake and sea. That is what we can inspect here in Denmark very soon. The blooming Hvidtjørn. It is a bush that has long, this sticks to you, but it's good for the bees. And now we have the Vintergækker, and it's everywhere in our gardens. And that is Danish, the best sign for every one of us, you and I, that the springtime is coming. Even it has been a very tough year for every one of us around the world. But here you see the beautiful Vintergækken. And that is what we do with the paper cutting. We make paper cuts, all kind of beautiful. And then we said a little, mit navn det står med prikker, pas på det ikke stikker. My name is set with dot, dot, dot. And be careful, it's not hurting you. And then we put small Vintergækker inside. And then you have to find out how many dot, dot, dot is there? Could it be from Benedicta or from Bruce or from Linda or from Alice? So that is, and if they can find out that it was actually from Benedicta, then I have to get give them a Easter egg, and another way on, they have to get one. So that is a påske funny thing. Thank you, dear. This was the session for tonight. I hope you enjoyed it. Take care.
Thank you, Benedicta. Another great program. We had a few questions, and there were some comments from people. And it is so special because there are people joining us today that have personal connections, family in some of these places, and close ties to these places. And it just makes it very special to be able to see them. And the pictures that you have from those towns and different locations. So it's very special. Thank you for the questions. We have a few. Can you talk about, or do you know if there are any mineral hot springs for healing anywhere in Denmark? Like there is in Iceland.
Yeah. Actually, not really one I can, there must be. I know there's one at Samsø. At Samsø there is a little spot down on the beach, and it is, they call it a holy, in Helikilde. Helikilde, and that is that when you go to that water, it's running all the time, it have some healings in it, and what is this called? It's maybe I will find it to next time. But it is a very, that is for Samsø, and but there is some places. When compared to if we go to for example Germany, every single town in Germany that have the name Bad, like that is Bath. Bad Hersfeld, Bad Kistinger, Baden-Baden. It's all about that they have holy kills that you can come and get healed of that. Some for hearts and some for skin and some for that. but we have some, but not very many. No.
Okay.
Yeah.
Another question. I believe you've met the Queen, Queen Margrethe, haven't you, Benedicta?
Yes, but never been able to talk or have a dinner together.
Okay. Well, maybe you've met people that have had conversations. What is it like to meet the Queen?
I mean, we feel that we have met her. I feel I have met her so many times because you can see how many times I can bring picture of about her or with her entire life and her sisters and her kids and her family, because she is so wonderful, open to us, to the people of Denmark, to everyone. She just wants to be a part of it. She gives whatever she have to feel. She still has the distance. It is still the majesty. But in another way, she has this enormous, nice way to be not close to us, but she still wants to have the distance. But she let us be a part of her life. You see, like she sit there in Bodø and see her garden, and then she grows something. And she is really a part of our daily day's life. And then still can keep the distance and respect. And that is how I love her. I respect her. She is an incredible ambassador for Denmark around the world. And that is also why our business, if we have our Denmark's government travel to whatever state it is, they bring so many people. Gunfors, Danfors, Lego, Maersk, and name them, Carlsberg, Tuborg. And it is a success because of our royal family. They are the symbol of the little fairy tale country in Denmark, the Hans Christian Andersen's fairy tale. It is a real queen. It is a real crown prince or princess. And that make it so all the journalists come in so many numbers because of that. If it just was our prime minister, they will not show up there. Nothing compared to when the Queen is there. So that makes such a difference that we have this wonderful, wonderful monarch. Yeah.
Well, and they present themselves so well. And with all the drama that we've seen, you know, the last few days with the British royal family, the Danish royal family just presents themselves so well and represents the country so well. And it just doesn't seem like there's the issues with them. So it's definitely the country can be proud of the Danish royal family.
I could tell you a little story. I think I have been about 10 years old. My mom was down there in Sydslesvig. You saw that is the series about Kong Christian and when we had about the board and all that. And mom were part of that and she went to a meeting and we were alone home at our farm på Rømø, på Tæhongård. And the phone rang and I grabbed it and there's a voice that say, "Good day, Benedicte." Good day. Det er kongen. Did come with what? I was shocked. It is the king. I said, "Kong Frederik." "Yes, ja, min pige, det er kongen. How are you doing? Hvordan har I det?" He said, "Vi har det godt. Min mor, are your mom home?" "No, mor er der nede til Sønderjyske møde, og det er godt." And we were sitting talking, and he just asked, hvordan har dine søskende det, Nikolaj og Annemette? And I said, "They are doing great. We're all doing fine." And it was just, I couldn't believe it. And he was so wonderful to talk to. He was had so much time, and he just asked and asked. Anyway, when my mom come home, I said, "Mom, I talked to the Kong Frederik today." And she said, "What?" I said, "Yeah, he called us." And yes, that is just a picture of how down to earth they are and they were.
Yeah. What a great story and what a great memory.
Yeah, so cute.
I want to ask you a question about one of our attendees, Virginia, is talking about how close her ties are to the town of Kooling. And the story, she says, the story I have is that there was a seminary and many of that group in the seminary took on the Kooling name. Do you know anything about the group from that, about those people from Kooling?
No, I would just turn my light. I think it's too, a little bit too sharp. No, but I know that many people take, for example, the name, of Nyborg or Kolding or Vejle, whatever. You could tell here the paper museum's lady, that's, her last name is Vejle. And very often it is because they want to bring the line to the town where they come from. We have in Oregon, we have something called John Reerslev, and Reerslev in Junction City, he comes from the Reerslev på Sjælland. And so they have often that they take the name of the town where they come from to have the connection. Okay. That is the most normal, yeah.
And then the bridge walk on the Lillebælt. Can tourists do that? Are you harnessed? Are you connected to the bridge when you're walking up there and getting up very high? What can you tell us about
that? It is like it was in Australia and it's everywhere. You sign up weeks ahead. It's so fully booked the most of a year. So you have to be really in good time to book that you want and know that you have that you are able to do it. But it's only for really well people in well shape. And they get a real costume and all that. And it is set time exactly. And there's some people there to take care of them too. So it is running like you go into a carousel or whatever, you want to flying balloons or whatever. It is just the same. You need to have this action in your life and sort of walk the bridge. And that's very popular, very popular. And they have so much advertising for come and stay by the Lillebælt and all the hotels down there nearby. They say, oh, come on, you can have the bridge walk. So it's something fun for people that are able to do it.
Thank you. You were talking about the whiskey distillery, and of course this is with Per Gregersen passing away last week. Very dear to me because he was married to my cousin. Lisa is asking, what was the name again of the distillery with the Nimbus whiskey?
It is a Trollen. Trollen is a little, du kan have Trollen. Troll is something from, not a fairy tale, but it's from the storytelling for kids that there can be a troll in school, you can have a troll in the forest. I don't know what the troll is på English, but that is the name of it, Trollen i Kolding.
And I'll just add, there were several, over the last 10 years or so, there's been several distilleries that have started in Denmark. And this book, I would just say, if you have any questions about this, send me an email and I can get you information. I can show you where to order the book. The book is in Danish, but we can certainly get information if you would like that. I'm hoping if I can go to Denmark this summer that I can tour some of the distilleries. That was something that Per and I had hoped to do, just wasn't meant to be when he passed away. So that was sad.
And the book is very pretty. It's a very nice book. I have it right here on my table. It's a gorgeous book. And thank you. It's just very nice. And we will, in the next session, when we come to Nyborg, there is a distillery too, and I have a picture from that too, from inside, and there's a story special with that, so.
Yeah, and it's really interesting what they've done with some of those distilleries, with some of the buildings that they've used, and so. Yes. We had a question, what is the name of the first spring flower? What is the English name of it?
Yes, yeah, so normally it is Iranthus. Iranthus, that is the little yellow, very little yellow. It's also blooming right now, normally in February, but we have had all this frost. So it's very, very tiny, just 2-3 inches from the ground. And that is the first one, Iranthus. And then right. Becomes the winter gecko, what you see here. And then you have, then more and more will come. Small hyacinths and all that. But Iranthus, yeah, what is that called in English? I'll find that till next time. I found some, can you remember, there was some that asked when I had a layer cake with some yellow flowers on. And then they asked, what is the name of that flower? And that is, as they were tallerkensmækker in Danish, the yellow in all kind of yellow color, and you could eat it. And it is called plate B-I-B, but I think it's plate ip. That is tallerkensmækker.
Okay.
Well, yeah.
Good, thanks. Thanks for that. Let's see, I think that is all the questions, and that's about all that we have time for. Thank you again, Benedicta, for a wonderful program. Mm-hmm. And I want to say, just please note that the webinar link that you received is the same one each week. So we'll continue that, and we'll continue that also for the additional programs that we'll be having. So I hope you can join us for the rest of these programs all through the month of March and into April. And our next presentation will be next Tuesday, the 16th of March at 11 a.m. Chicago time. Benedicta mm-hmm. will take us to Odense, Tosinga, Esko, Nubo, and Corsair, and also Roskilde.
Yeah.
So please join us. Thank you on behalf of the NFDA, the Danish Pioneer, Alice, Linda, and Benedicta. See you next week, everyone. Thank you.
Thank you.